peace and blessings, beautiful souls. I am Brandi L. Bates, author of Moonshine for the Soul and other books. You can find me on Twitter at Soledad Francis and on Instagram at Brandi is Winning. Most of these podcasts can be found on YouTube and SoundCloud, hashtag Power Podcasts. Tonight I'm talking about the impact of Goya. The impact of Goya. And Goya simply stands for get off your ass. Everything you will ever want out of this life will come when you Goya. Goya will help you build both your interior and exterior empires. Goya will help you leave your indelible mark on humanity and your legacy on this planet. At the seat of all greatness, it doesn't matter if it's in sports, entertainment, in the business world, in our personal relationships and interpersonal relationships, at the seat of that is us, you, me, getting off our ass. The unconscious mind is always listening. The reason why I say this is control of consciousness determines the quality of life. Because you see, be it pain or pleasure, they only exist in consciousness. Stay with me, follow me. Life will bring you pain all by itself. You don't have to go looking for shit. Shit will find you. Your responsibility is to create joy. Your daily behavior reflects your deepest beliefs. So many of us are addicted to pain, addicted to making excuses. What do I mean by that? I know on its face, it sounds hella crazy. Like, you know, I'm not addicted to pain. You know, your average person, especially those who are notorious for being addicted to pain, addicted to making excuses, addicted to bullshit, they're gonna deny it. But the truth of the matter is, take a good look at your life. Look at the results in your life, because your life is one big snapshot of results that you've created. Now, I know there's some people that are like, well, you know, I couldn't help who I was born to, or, you know, I couldn't help who my parents are. I'm not even talking about all of that. Your life is one big snapshot of the thoughts you think, the shit you do and don't do, your success and failures, whether that's in relationships, baby mamas, baby daddies, divorces, marriages, broken relationships, broken promises, you name it. You can't control the color of your eyes, you can't control the color of your skin, but your life, how you're living, the money you're making, your happiness, your sadness, your relationships, your health, your state of mind, even down to the way you look, your physical appearance, it's all you, boo. It's all you. And so our well-intended parents or grandparents or whoever raised you, they program us with the beliefs that were wired into them. So a lot of times you'll have, you know, you may want to be a successful entrepreneur. And it's unfortunate that so much of our environment shapes and molds us into who we are. And so what happens is you may want to aspire to be a successful entrepreneur or an author, or you may aspire to be a firefighter. You may aspire to be an astronaut. You may aspire to be the next great chef, you know, world class, world famous chef. But let's just say your parents, they are blue collar workers, and all they've ever known is the factory or the 9-to-5 or the cubicle or the third shift. You get my drift, right? You follow me. Stay with me. You follow me. They're going to say little shit. And 9 times out of 10, most of us, we lived in the same household and under the same roof with our parents for 18 to 21 to 30 years. Some of us, right? So for 18 years, you were being programmed by someone with a very limited capacity, limited goals. I'm not clowning. I'm not bagging your parents. I'm saying the truth of the matter is you've been programmed by someone, and whatever their limitations and lack of Goya or excuses for not getting off the ass was embedded in you. It was embedded in your DNA. It was embedded in your genetics. You heard it day in and day out. You heard it for 16, 17, 18 years, day in and day out. What do you think your predominant programming is going to be? So many of us, I may not be talking to you, but many of us are up against a losing battle in the sense that we are trying to rewire our whole way of being. Okay? They have well intentions for you. But what did they program? What are some of your beliefs? What are some of your ideas? And sometimes you don't have to say it because you're living it. Most people aren't aware of their belief systems. And when I say that, I'm deeply sincere. Most people don't even, they're not even aware of the shit they believe and how fallacious it can be. And how it can be self-defeating in the things that they say they want. Study the alchemy. Look for the gold. Always look for the best in every single situation you find yourself in. Always look for the best solid in someone. Even if you can't find anything but their voice and you're like, well, you know, he has a sexy ass voice, or, you know, she is, at the end of the day, you know, she's cool. You have to find the best in people. This is studying the alchemy. This is training your brain to see opportunities and fuel in the so-called setbacks or obstacles you find yourself faced with in your day-to-day. See the gold in the lead. See the monumental, magnanimous, magnificent, and marvelous redwood or pine, great 100-foot pine tree. See it in the acorn. See it in it in the seed stage. See the gold in the lead. See the diamond in the rough. Because many of us, we want the diamond already spit shine, polished, you know, clarity cut. But it's not going to come to you like that. And I've said it before. We want shit already fully formed in fashion when that's your job. We want our parents. We want our providers. We want our teachers. We want our professors. We want our, you know, we want things given to us. And for lack of better words, we want to take the easy route. We want the path of least resistance. That's human nature. That's, I don't care who you, I don't care how sanctimonious and special you believe you are. That's all of us. We are all guilty of it. But that's not the way this life works. That's not the way the world works. I would love for it to, but that's not the way it works. See the gorgeous opportunity in your setbacks and your obstacles, because that's where they are. They are not going to come to you fully fashioned and formed. And so many of us, we don't want to do the bare basic necessities. I can't tell you how many people first things first, if I mentor you, the first thing I say to you is, give me a list of 101 things you want to do, places you want to go. What do you want to have? Who do you want to be over the course of your life? I'm not talking about what do you want today. I'm not saying what do you want this year. Over the course of your life, in the next 10 years, in the next 20 years, in the next 30 years, where are some places you'd like to visit? Where are some countries you would like to touch the soil? What cars would you like to drive? What experiences would you like to experience? And then in addition to that, I say, bring me a business plan. Because money makes this world spin around. Ain't shit coming to you for free, but hard times. Hard times are gonna come to you for free. I can guarantee you that. I promise you that. But there are so many people, they don't even want to do that. I can't help you get from point A to point B if you don't even know where point B is. We have to see it together, right? You can't get in your car and turn on a GPS system and say, okay, I know where I am, but I don't know where I want to go. Guess where you're going to go? That part. So ask yourself, are you a hoarder? Are you a hoarder of more negative thoughts or positive thoughts? And understand whichever thoughts that you hoard, because all of us hoard thoughts to a degree. Whichever thoughts you hoard most of the time are going to grow into the trees and then forests of your life. Well, they say you can't see the tree, you can't see the forest for the trees. 85% of what you expect to happen will happen. And here's the kicker. All the bad shit, if you expect it and you put enough energy and fuel behind that expectation, I promise you, it's gonna come to pass. Because a real expectation, again, is tied into your belief system. And most of us have the expectations that we have, whether it be in marriage, whether it be on our jobs, in our careers, in our relationships, with regards to our body, our image, the way we see ourselves. And that when I say the way we see ourselves, I'm not just talking about the way you see, when you look at yourself in the mirror, the way you see yourself. Most people, you know, they think they're beautiful. Most people look for the good in themselves. But again, when I say, how we see ourselves, how do you see yourself as a woman? How do you see yourself as a man? How do you see yourself as a quote unquote black man or woman, or a Caucasian man or woman, or Latina man or woman? Or how do you see yourself as a manager or a supervisor or an entrepreneur or a janitor? How do you see yourself as an employee of McDonald's or of the Apple store, the Apple company? How do you see yourself as a wife or as a husband, as a mother, as a father? What are the beliefs behind those labels, right? And because it's tied into your belief system is the reason why even highly motivated people can't get ahead at times. I'm going to touch on this some more later, but understand, because somewhere ingrained in our thinking, usually due to an earlier experience, is the belief that we can't. Deep down, you're already defeated in your mind. You're already defeated in your thoughts. You're already defeated because some shit that happened when you was a kid, or some shit that was said to you by somebody who didn't, you know their ass from a hole in a wall, said something to you and embedded a seed of doubt. And that's how you're carrying that. And it's causing you to shut down on your own motivation to do the shit you came here to do. Are you following me? You don't get lucky. You make lucky. You don't get success. You make success. You're not gonna wake up wealthy. You have to make that happen. You have to get off your ass. Nothing is falling from the skies. I don't care how much you pray for it. I don't care how much you meditate about it. I don't care how much yoga you do. I don't care how much chanting you do. I don't care if you pay for it. You have to get off your ass. We're talking about the impact of Goya. If you're interested in something, you're gonna do what's convenient. But if you're committed, you'll do whatever it takes. And that's what separates the real ballers and shot callers from everybody else. That's what separates the CEOs and those who stroke checks versus those who go cash checks and go clock up a time clock. I'm not clowning. I'm not bagging on you, but I'm stating facts. And if you're okay with where you are in your life, fine. You're good. I'm good. If you're good with where you are, wonderful. You can teach the world a whole lot. But for the vast majority of us, we're not really where we want to be. And that's what life's about. Getting from where you are to where you want to be. Everyone is on their grand heroic journey in this life. Allow yourself to see what you don't allow yourself to see. Allow yourself to see what you don't allow yourself to see. That starts with being where your feet are. Be here now. I can't explain to you how many people will spend the vast majority of their weekend with their face in a screen. People who will pay good money to go on a beautiful vacation, to spend the vast majority of that time on Twitter, on Facebook, looking at some shit other people got going on that's not as nearly interesting as what you have going on. Will spend their time watching the news on TV, watching shows, watching movies, and not really fully engaged in the experience at hand, and that's life. Now, I'm not hating. I'm not saying, you know, I like to jump on and off of Twitter every now and then, jump on and off of Instagram, because I know, you know, that's the day and age we live in, you know. But the fact of the matter is, you have to be fully engaged in living. Everything you, listen to me, because y'all playing. And life is too short for the bullshit. I'm sincere about that. Hear me when I tell you, I'm not doing this shit for my health. I'm hoping to touch somebody, impact somebody. Somebody can say, you know what? I got my shit together because something she said sunk down in my spirit and made me really get off my ass. Life is so short. And you're gonna turn around and realize how much time you've wasted on some bullshit. Allow yourself to see what you don't allow yourself to see. Be here now. All of everything that you want in this life is going to come from another person. Yes, it's going to start with your thoughts. It's going to convert into your actions and getting off your ass and making it happen, putting forth action, putting forth effort, but the rest of it is going to come from another person. And even if it's your own business, it's going to come from customers, clients. If you're an athlete, it's going to come from those people who come and buy tickets to come see you perform. If you're an artist or a musician, it's going to come from people paying good hard money for your talent. If it's a job, it's going to be because of the economy, because of a supervisor, because of a business that strikes a check for you every 2 weeks and offers you a 401k and offers you healthcare benefits, but it's going to come from people. And so the best best thing you can do is strengthen your ability to understand people, to deal with people, know how to read people, and know how to influence people. Most powerful thing that ever I could have ever learned and realized was when I read that book about winning friends and influencing people. That's half the battle. But you won't know that if you're sitting in a room full of influencers and people who can, quite frankly, change the entire trajectory of your life. But you're on Twitter, you're on Instagram, you're on Snapchat. You too busy putting dog ears on your fucking filter to sit in a room and realize who and what type of opportunities are facing you. Y'all not gonna like me after this podcast. What is easiest to see is often overlooked. That's why they say, if you wanna hide something, hide it in plain sight. Because what's the easiest to see? We're not even paying attention to it. It's so easy to get caught up in the thick of thin things. Sometimes I just observe people. I observe how the news will spin things and give us something, and everybody's attacking it and attaching emotion to it. And then 2 days later, you won't hear anything else about it. And then 3 days later, they'll present you with something else, some new tragedy or chaos or war or bad guy or, you know, boogeyman of some sort, the communists or the terrorists, or you attach the suffix or the prefix, and we get all caught up and up in arms about it, and we write about it, and we're angry about it, and we're having, you know, full blown out arguments and debates with people about shit that somebody else engineered to get you worked up, and they laughing at it. Oh, look at the ratings, you know, and going to the bank. And I just observe people and realize how we get so caught up in major and the minor things and all the important shit we minor on. You know, I don't want to keep beating. I don't want to beat the dead horse anymore. But I've talked about generational wealth. And anybody who's listening to me, if you've been following any of my podcasts, following my emails to all my mentees and following me on Twitter, or you name it. I've always been about financial empowerment. I've always been about financial freedom. I've always been about generational wealth. And it's like, you would think that all the resources out here for us to be wealthy and really paid and really, I mean, really, really setting the stage for an amazing legacy, you would think it wasn't even out here the way people act. The way people are struggling. How are you educated and you're struggling, begging for crumbs? How do you have so many, you have degrees on the wall, and you gotta beg a man for crumbs to survive? What did you learn? I don't care. You can hotep me into the ground, but if you don't know how to heal yourself, you don't know how to build and engineer and create for yourself, it means nothing. It's empty. So seductive to spend your finest hours climbing mountains that at the end turn out to be the wrong ones. Listen, tonight I want you to turn the mirror upon yourself. And I'm not being funny. Turn the mirror upon yourself. So often we point out all the shit that others do to us and totally negate or ignore all the shit we do unto others. And you see it in the memes on social media. You hear it when people are talking. It's always about what, you know, watch what they do to you. Keep your circle small, because they, you know, or they're going to try to do this, or people will do that. But what about you? You're people. We're people. I'm people. When you say, as you know, as a woman, when I say, well, you know, women, this and this and this, I'm talking about myself, right? If you're Chinese and you're like, well, you know, Chinese people this and Chinese people that, well, you're also talking about yourself. So I'm saying the point of the matter is, do unto others, accept your flaws the same way you accept and love those closest to you, flaws and all. Because, you know, we have, you know, as a parent, you see your kids' flaws. I see them all the time. I'm like, where did I go wrong? Where did I drop the ball? Where did I go wrong? You know, and the same goes for you. Accept your flaws, because truth be told, those who love you, I mean, really love you and know you and are closest to you, they love you in spite of you. They love you even though you messy, even though you may be a pathological liar, you're passive aggressive or lazy. And they're well aware, you know, those of you that at times you're just full of shit. You're full of shit. And you know you're full of shit. Or you procrastinate. Your life is just one big procrastination. But you know what? Those who truly are behind you, they love you in spite of it all. They don't care. They'll take you. Blemished and messy and all. Become more tomorrow than you are today. I know you often hear become better today than you were yesterday, but I'm saying today, really, become more tomorrow than you are today. What does that mean? Follow me. You do this by getting better and better and better daily. It may start mentally, but at some point you got to get off your ass and you have to either get in the gym or get in the yoga studio or go do Pilates or go ride a bike. It can be doing calisthenics. It can be roller skating. It can be playing bowling. It can be playing golf. It can be playing basketball. It can be weight training. I don't care, but it's getting off your ass and you do this day by day. Life is a series of seasons. Don't resist the natural flow of seasons. There will be times where you'll be all the way up. All the way up. We all the way up. And there are going to be times when you're depleted. Bottom line, accept it. Embrace it and move on. And that's life. That's life. You're never going to be all the way up all the time. Just like you may go through a hiccup or bad times, you're not going to always go through bad times. Life has natural seasons. The same way we have summer, winter, spring, and fall. We have different times. We have different seasons. That's the way your life works. And understand it, learn how to detect it when you're going through various seasons and roll with it. Something that you may or may not be doing already. Touch your goals daily for at least an hour a day. Touch your goals. Touch them. That means you got to be looking at them. First, you got to have them written out, right? You got to write some shit out or type it out. You have to have goals to begin with. And then you got to touch them every day. Physically touch it. Read out loud to yourself. Read it in your head and touch them. Touch your goals every day for at least an hour a day. When was the last time you touched your goals physically? I challenge you to do a 66-day journal ritual where you document where you're winning in life. Where are you winning in life? What are some of your wins? Because, I mean, we can always be like, well, yeah, you know, I'm broke or I'm going through this or I haven't been feeling good or, you know. But where are you winning? Train your brain where you see where you're winning. What are you grateful for in your life? What are three things each day that happened on that day that were monumentally off the chain? And actually put pen to paper. Or, you know, you may have an app where you type in your little notes or whatever, but it's getting the mind to really do the exercise and building the muscle to start to see your wins. Because where you focus is where all the energy is going to go. We take so much shit for granted. I mean, it's like not even funny. It's unreal how much shit we take for granted. It's to the point when as soon as I hear someone start complaining, anyone who knows me, I'm looking at you, but I'm really not agreeing with you. I'm hearing you, but I'm not listening, because life is so wonderful when you just look at the whole scope and grand scheme of things. And if you live in North America, or you live in London or France, or, you know, any developed nation, you are so blessed when most of the world is living on $2 a day. You are insanely wealthy. You have your health, you have your mind, you have family, you have loved ones, you have love, you have money, you know. Focus on that and let that be a catalyst to say, I want more. I want to do more and I want to leave more, right? Don't ever compare your life to where it appears everyone else is, because everything isn't what it seems. Everyone is struggling with something. Believe that. Amazing what happens to your self-identity and confidence when you transcend procrastination and do what you need to do, no matter how hard. Goya. Get off your ass. Get off your ass. Stay in your lane. And when I say, because I say it a lot, when I say stay in your lane, I mean more specifically, hone in on your life and what it is that you came here to do. Even if you don't have it all mapped out, because none of us has all the answers, but focus on where you are in your life. Who can you help? Who can you impact? And dwell in that. And as you do that better, you're going to rise and rise and rise and rise. See, a lot of people never rise from their station in life because they don't have a large enough impact on the world. That partly starts from not reading enough, not knowing enough, limited in your knowledge. I don't even want to say necessarily, you know, classic education, you know, having degrees and going on to medical school or business school or engineering. No, it means your breadth of knowledge, your depth of knowledge. Okay, because there's a lot of educated fools. But my point is, if you lack knowledge, the more ignorant you are, it's going to stymie you. It's going to keep you in a lower station in life. And when I say ignorance, that can mean ignorance of whatever situation you find yourself in, or it could just mean broad garden variety ignorance. Case in point, I don't know how to work on cars. I am a woman's woman when it comes to that. I'm a girly girl, and I'm like, I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know what's under there. I just know I put the key in and I go, you know. And because of the ignorance there, because I'm ignorant of cars, I'm ignorant of the mechanics and the engine and the catalytic converter and how the impact of an oil change and et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Because I'm ignorant of that, I have to pay money to take it somewhere, you know, to be serviced, to be stationed. So that means my ignorance in that situation keeps me in a low station. It's going to cost me. It's going to cost me money because I'm ignorant of how to do it myself. And so my point is, the more you know about shit, the higher you'll rise. The more you're not only going to save money, but you're going to make money. You're going to create avenues for it to come to you the more you know. Stay with me. Exceptional achievement without ongoing enjoyment is an empty win. Yes! Own your craft. Produce your mastery. Exploit your potential. But travel. Travel widely. Anytime you have an opportunity to travel, and I say it all the time, travel. If you can travel around the world and you can afford it, travel around the world. There is a whole big world out there with billions and billions and billions of people. Life is so much bigger than you and your family and your household and your job, or, you know, there's a whole world out there. Go see it. If you can only afford to travel around your country, travel around your country. If you can only afford to travel around your city, travel around your city. Go to a different zip code. Go to a different restaurant. Go to a different mosque or church. Visit a temple for a change. Visit different parks or forests or lakes or beaches or rivers or mountains. Travel. Read deep books. And when I say that, read everything. Read everything. Read self-help books, but read business books. Read politics. Read about poetry. Read great poets. Read great autobiographies. Hell, read smut every now and then. Read, I don't care if you're reading Playboy. I don't care if you're reading Mademoiselle. Read. Read everything you can get your hands on, because you don't know where the great idea is going to come from that's going to totally revolutionize your life. Like, you can't even believe. Laugh. My mother used to say, laughter is a cure-all. And it really is. Like, if you're ever in a bad mood, in a bad space, and you just feeling just foul, and, you know, you're like, fuck the world, you know, you having a day, you're having a moment, pop in a comedy, turn on a comedy, go on YouTube and watch some stand-up, watch some funny movies, go to a stand-up comedian show, an actual comedy show, you know. Get around the funniest people you know. We all have that one friend that just keeps you in stitches because they are so freaking funny and they make you laugh no matter what. Get them on the phone. Get them on FaceTime. Get with them in person. But laugh. Laugh loudly with love. And savor inspirational art. When's the last time you've been to an art gallery? Art gallery. I'll wait. When is the last time you've been to a museum? When is the last time you explored a different platform, a different medium of art? When is the last time you attended a concert? Eat awesome food. I like to say, you know, eat for your blood type and eat for your body. Not just the body you have, but the body you're trying to create. Because our bodies are made up of what we've eaten. What we eat are the building blocks of our body. So, you know, in other words, you are what you eat. So I like to say, you know, eat for your blood type and eat for your body, but eat awesome food. A good friend of mine calls it sexy food, you know, because this life is, I'm telling you, this life is short. You here today. On a side note, a somber note, just last week, babe and I, we were heading out for the day and there was all this traffic, and come to find out, to make the long story short, this man had lost his life in a motorcycle accident. We passed by the scene. He was on a motorcycle. The police and the first responders had draped this red tarp over him, but you could tell that it was a dead body. One of the second dead bodies I've seen in, you know, in my adult life. But I can't tell you just how choked up I got seeing it. But this man was driving a motorcycle, and I guess a truck rear-ended him, I'm assuming. I don't know, I wasn't there, but his motorcycle was literally cut in half, and you saw his shoes. Upon impact, I guess his shoes flew off. You saw his shoes and everything, but they, you know, he was gone. And it just, the thought that came to me as I saw that was, you're here today, you're gone tomorrow. And how many of you don't realize the conversation you're having with someone may be the last conversation you have with them. Never leave a conversation, you know, in negativity on some, fuck you, you know, don't call me, hey, because that may be the last conversation you have with that person, especially family, your mother, your father, your sister, your brother, your kids, your loved ones. Man, we're all here today, gone tomorrow. Life is so tremendously short. So I just was saying that to say, you know, live your life, travel, read, eat good food, get out and live life. Get off the fucking computer, get off the apps and go live life. Go to the beach, go hiking, go barefoot, you know, go play with the kids. But because you gotta savor this life. GOYA! Get off your ass. Spend time in nature. The world belongs to the learners. And you want to know why so many empires fall? So many empires fall because the human brain and spirit craves novelty. And so we grow and expand our capacities by doing difficult things. That's why as children, you go from first grade to second grade, so forth and so on and so on and so on. Because you need to constantly be challenged and you need to constantly be growing. So the thing about success is when it shows up, it's easy to lose the hunger, the sincerity, the empathy, the industry and relatability that got you there. In other words, when you're pursuing that woman, all the shit you did to get her, once you have her, goes out the window. Cause you're like, oh, I have her, right? Once all the shit you did to get that job, remember you applied and you did your fingerprints and you got drug tested and you drove for one interview and another interview and another interview and you got the job. And now 6 months into the job, a year into the job, and you're like, fuck this shit, you know? Fuck all of them, you know? And that's for many of us because we lose that passion. So it's one thing to be, you know, successful, and it's something totally altogether different to sustain success. That's why it's easy for a lot of champions. It's a lot of champions who they get a ring or they win the title once or twice, or they win the gold medal once or twice. But for them to do it consistently year over year, over year, over year, for a lifetime is very rare. Ask yourself, are you playing the short game or the long game? Because at the seat of GOYA is the idea of living with death in mind. Not in a sad and depleting way, but with the mindset and the heart set that you and I never know when our last day will show up. GOYA, getting off your ass, is about world-class energy. Without world-class energy, you'll never produce world-class results. It's just not gonna happen. And as you become more successful, as your bank account grows, you must read more books. If 10 years ago you were reading a book a week, or a book a year, then you need to be reading a book a month. If last year you were reading a book a month, you need to start reading a book a week. Grow in knowledge, because the world belongs to the learners. The faster you learn and the more you learn, the higher you're going to rise in this life. Surround yourself with young people, even if you don't agree with how they do shit, because they're our future. Be more punctual, more passionate. Again, as the more and more success comes to you, you want to be more passionate. You want to be more focused. You want to go even harder. When you thought you used to get up early before, get up earlier. And watch what happens. Watch what happens. Make time to get away from your office. Spend more time in nature. I mean, really get your ass in nature. Go to the beach, go to the lake, go to the river, go to the mountains, get in nature. Savor the taste of nature. The world outside of the cubicle, the world outside of the fluorescent lights, the world outside of the desktop computer or the tablet, the world, the carbon-based biological world. Practice solitude daily. I was just reading somewhere how they say the longer people spend in solitary confinement, the more likely they are to start developing hallucinations and begin to start hearing things and seeing things. The mind, in other words, the mind starts wrapping around itself. The unconscious mind starts to wrap itself around the subconscious mind. The subconscious mind, the unconscious, and the conscious mind all begin to braid together the more you spend time in solitude. And depending on where you are in your consciousness is what you will hear and what you will see. That's why you have some people who are schizophrenic. They may see angels. They may see spirit guides. They may even see into the future. They're not crazy. Just because we put that label schizophrenic, they're not crazy. But if they are on a higher level vibration, a higher level of consciousness, they're going to see spirit guides. They're going to see indigo children. They're going to see people's chakras. They're going to see people's electromagnetic auras. And then those who are on a lower vibrational frequency, they're going to see demons. There certain people who do psychotropic drugs, they're going to either go on a certain kind of trip that takes them to another dimension, because the psychotropic drugs split the veil. They split the veil so you can see the different dimensions. That's another show. But the bottom line is, depending on where your consciousness is where you will trip off to, depending on where you are vibrationally, will determine the dimensions that you see, the beings, the hyperdimensional, and you will be able to astral project based on your consciousness. Again, another show, but the point is, you have to practice solitude. So you can start listening to your thoughts and getting in your own mind. Not what the world gives you. Not what media gives you. Not what the power elite give you. Read magazines you don't ordinarily read. Or wouldn't ordinarily read. Travel. Again, go to an art gallery. Prime your creativity. Do some shit you never would have ever imagined yourself doing in like 100 years. Like, go to a country western spot and get in the line dance with them. You know, that's something I would never do. But now that I've said it, look, I gotta do it, right? I gotta do it now. But use every day as a vehicle to birth your talents into the world. And as you do this, you're gonna raise the world and the level of consciousness of everyone around you. And that includes yourself. Do not let anything interrupt those tasks that are most critical for your growth in the important areas of your life. Find a way, no matter what, to prioritize your daily process goals, even when you have a viable excuse to justify not doing it. The impact of getting off your ass is understanding that the only true obstacles in life are self-imposed. You always have the choice to stay down or rise up. And in truth, the only real obstacles to your ultimate success will come from within yourself and fall into one of the following, you know, three categories: apathy, laziness, and or fear. So commit today to do shit at the highest level. Get off your ass. I might challenge you to start journaling each night. What are your wins? Get out in nature. GOYA.